arguing against the Democrats, and the Democrats is still saying that he didn't get elected because it was all messed up. I was gonna heat up some Hebrew National or something in there.
Okay.
But I had to get this pain down in this bowl. And
sciatic nerve.
And so, let me go on here and read Paul's third journey of the coming of the Holy Spirit. A lame beggar was healed, page 460. I'm at the back of the book here. 462. Jesus ascended into heaven. Thomas doubted the breaking of bread. It's 11:30. What's on TV, guys?
TV.
Okay.
Well, you have to control your mind, and if you don't control your mind, then Satan will jump in it. The battlefield is the mind. And that what George Bond said?
Yeah.
It's a battlefield. So if we don't put God's word in our mind, then Satan has a free range to jump in there and have us thinking all kind of crazy thoughts. You see, and so this is what happened to you when you got upset about Easter seal. Your mind was wide open, and Satan just jumped right in there, and you were just so upset, and smoke was coming out of your ears and your nose. And I was saying, hey, Josh, and you couldn't understand. And we're going to sing this, and we're going to sing it, and we're going, and we're going.
I would like to do this. Whatever you emphasize to me. Wait, no.
It's not whatever anybody. It's you allow. And if you allow what God say, that will block out the devil. But you see what I'm saying? You can't just walk through this world or just whatever comes on TV, you accept it.
That's not what I'm saying.
You are saying the religious teaching at Easter Sunday that the girls could do anything and the boys could not. It was geared toward the girls, and it was geared toward that the boys would.
Well, you are so adamant.
telling me, no, that's not what it was, but I was there, and most of the movies were geared that way. When we had any sort of project, oh, don't get me started.
Joshua, I heard what you said. Didn't you hear what I said? It was geared for the girls.
Well, you keep telling me that it was all in my head.
No. What I'm saying is you should not have listened to that. Miss Mecca, but you went there. Oh. Did it bother? What's that man's name from Hawaii? What was his name? The one that said the pineapple wasn't grown from Hawaii?
Yeah, well, I can't remember his
Emmett,
name.
Emil, Desmond.
I don't remember his name, Mom.
It didn't bother him what they did. What they said, what the girls did, what you gonna
okay.
What's his name? Oh, wait a minute.
Everything I wanted to work on at the time the seals came in, so I was already under that stress. I'm going to give you the points. Take them. Don't get mad at me. This is what happened. My first mistake was taking photography and liking it. That was my first mistake. Because it got me attached to the computer in a way I never should have been attached. And when the computer crashed and I couldn't get the stuff back, that was a torment because at each stage of the crash, something could have been different and the problem be alleviated if not outright solved. And it took me 2.5 years to put into practice things that would keep the computer from crashing. And right on the edge of that, my back blew out the first time. So in 2015, when I got my back stable the first time, and I was confident enough to not have to worry about a computer crash because I was practicing what to do, I said to myself, this is the year. I'm going to work on my back, and then I'm going to go back to college on a relatively calm footing. And I said yes to Easter sales when I should have said no, I have some things I need to work on.
See, we're supposed to walk by faith. We're supposed to walk by sight. If God wants this, then I'm for what God wants. And if God don't want it, he'll block it. I used to pray about Daddy going to Georgia all the time. And I said, well, then, Lord, if you want me to go, then we need to have, like Gideon, then we need to have good weather all the way to the. And if that bad weather, then I know that you don't want me to go. And several times, when I
come on, say it.
When I had thought we should go. That was a tornado. Tab all the way from Louisiana all the way up to South Carolina. which was be our routine.
We walk by faith, not by sight.
That's right.
I'm not finished, but okay. Now you said that if you were gonna go to Georgia, you would need signs from God.
I don't want to go in no tornado. To me, that was the sign for me not to go.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Just like you don't want to go to Georgia when there's bad weather in between here and there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure I can take the next step, the next big step, without calm footing in the first place. That is the same thing, Mom.
But not only that, Daddy would hear on the news that there would be bad weather from East Texas all the way through to, was it West Virginia, whatever, and he would say that. But usually he'll say, "Are you gonna pack up? Are you gonna pack up? Oh, you gotta pack up?"
Okay.
You know, I mean, it shut his mouth. He didn't want me driving through no tornado neighbor. So I wouldn't have to say, "Honey, there's bad weather." I didn't even have to say nothing. Mm-hmm. So, when you're looking to God and you're waiting on you, you're acknowledging Him, He will direct your path. And so you don't have to go back and start chewing on the what happened in the past. And I should have done this. And I should have done that. And that. Because you can still take pictures and be a photographer. Just because you got a little snag in, on the way in the middle, like Joseph was put down in the well. And then Potiphar's wife lied on him. And he stayed in prison for a couple more years. The man got out and said, "Okay, Joseph, when I get out of here, I'm going to remember you." And Joseph said, "Please don't forget me. I'm still
here." And he forgot for 2 years, at least. So.
But when God gave the dream to Pharaoh, and Pharaoh, he said, he woke up, he said, "This dream is bothering me, and I don't know what it means." So he called his dreamers to his room or chambers, and he said, "Now tell me what this dream means." And they said, "Well, if you tell us what the dream was, then we could tell you what the dream is." He said, nah. "You ain't the right one. If the dream came from you, then you ought to tell me what the dream was. And then you can tell me what it means." He said, "Well, we can't tell you what it meant if you don't tell us what it was." He said, "Yes, you can."
Okay.
He said, "You know, when he was a wise person in that sense that if it came from God, somebody else ought to know. And he don't have to tell you what it was. The person that it came from, that God gave it, would give it to, they could tell him what it was." And so Joseph said, "Okay, King, give me 3 days, I'll tell you what it was, and I'll tell you what it means." If Joseph was that strong in his connection with God, then there's some bad things that happened to Joseph along the way. And most people would say, "Oh, God ain't with me. God gave me that dream about the stars bowing down to me, and I don't know." Yeah. It was just a hoax. It was just a hoax. from God when you know beyond the shadow of a doubt. Now, how did that person know that about me? I didn't tell them that.
Okay.
And I tell you over and over how God brought me through. Going to staff and going to North Texas and getting a job and yada, yada, yada. And you come right back around like a broken record. And all those things Mama went through, but it ain't going to happen to me. I'm going to fall down, skin my knee, and, you know, brush my tooth out of there. Just hold on. Just hold on. And stop talking to me. And stop doubting God. But the way it happened for me, it may not happen like that for you. But then again, it might, you may connect some dots. And Joseph didn't have anybody to talk with, to confide in, to pray with him. In fact, at one point he said, "Now, God, you gave me that dream, and I don't see nothing. I don't see nothing that you're helping me with. Did you forget you gave me that dream? Did you? So I don't see nothing. I've been going through some bad times here. Just hold on.
Where is gurgling?
I don't hear any gurgle. You hear gurgling there?
Oh, the wieners are bubbling.
The wieners are bubbling. How in the world can you hear wieners bubbling?
Uh-huh.
Way over there, and I'm closer to the wieners, and I don't hear nothing.
First of all, you didn't take care of your ears. Second of all, it's quiet.
I still don't hear nothing. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I miss calling the same baby.
First of all, you like loud noises and you can't hear well in the first place. That's number one. Number two, it's quiet. That's why I can hear you can't.
I see. He's the bad. The blind man.
And
if
you're
blind, how can you see? I don't know, but I can see.
And maybe if we had the house quiet, we might could hear from God then and be calm. Like I said before, a few minutes ago, when it's quiet, I can just calm down, listen to whatever's going on, maybe hear from God.
Pour the water in the back of the coffee pot. Make sure it's all.
I see you. And I put it in there.
Oh.
And when I held it with my fist, when you turn it on and there's water over there, it likes to come up and push up on it.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'll have to try that another time.
Okay.
Things for me, and I wanted to hear the voice of God, and I wanted to. And I did not understand that God will talk to you when it is time, when He sees fit that you are ready, and you can't rush God. You shouldn't try to rush God. And I'm still like that. I still want God to talk with me and speak to me. And so a lot of that comes from praying in tongues. We were taught from Refuge that when you pray and you allow the Spirit of God, or the Holy Ghost, to talk through you, that's what you want, that's what you wait for. And after He talks through you, then you need an interpreter. And so Refuge was set apart. And the other churches would come and, you know, like, they would visit with us, and then they would look down their nose and say, oh, well, they like that, you know, we don't talk like that. We don't do that at our church. And I would say, well, get out of here then. How about I ask you to come over here? So you talk about church splits and misunderstandings, people that claim that they got the Spirit of God, and they're still arguing amongst themselves about as bad as